Since we all need to track checklists and surveys and questionnaires, dynamic assessment is a valuable tool to at least understand. Dynamic assessment lets you collect information that's tailored to specific participants or respondents. The example question they use is if you ask participants if they've skipped a meal, and the answer is yes, then dynamic assessments can say move on to a related question about how many times they've skipped. But if they didn't skip meals, then you can move on to the next group of questions. So these are the steps. So you're able to tailor the questionnaire to the specific needs of the participant respondent. They mention here that there's resources that you can look at. Now remember, this is in the Accelerate Impact with Outcome Management, Outcome Basics, Collecting Data. That's where this conversation started from. And dynamic assessment is an industry common component, which means that several clouds could use it. I'm recording this preview because what I'm suggesting is rather than watch these in sequence, I would encourage you to drop to 6:10 and watch this end-to-end video that shows how it works. This link takes you to dynamic assessments, and dynamic assessments, you'll see, is actually part of the inspection management. And you'll see in the regular playlist that it does strongly suggest that you understand the difference between these. So the first couple of videos work through this, and then we drop into the dynamic assessments. I ran into several errors in building the OmniScript. So I've added these videos as appendixes, just in case you also have some errors. So as a recap, I suggest you start with this 6:10 end-to-end, which does a good job of showing how to do the steps. I would make sure that you see that after you build an OmniScript, know that there can be delays. So if you don't see things happening, wait 30 seconds, because I found that was part of the source of my problems. With each video in the description, I've included a link to the overall playlist and then a way to jump between videos. Also included are the links to the outcome management and program management playlists. And after you watch this 6:10 end-to-end, I suggest you jump to this one, the 6A2, which is the object relationships. It walks through the various relationships. What is an Omni assessment task? What is the property set configuration field? And plenty of content here to take a look at. And if you haven't done the research, take a look at the velocity acquisition announcement, because I think that'll give you some context of why the Salesforce industry's structure is now in place. And I found this helpful too as I was thinking about how to build reports, given that there are several polymorphic fields that can point to various objects. With that, I hope this playlist is helpful. And don't hesitate to put some notes and comments in if you have questions.